Have you ever watched a video on YouTube and been annoyed by your lousy data connection? Of course, we have all been in need of a higher data rate. Maybe you can even feel it right now. In 60 GHz, there are vast amounts of unlicensed frequency bands that could be used to increase the data rate for you. In order to help you get higher data rates, we have chosen to design a communication system for 60 GHz. The goal of our communication system was real-time transmission to reach 100 kilobit per second, capability to transmit files of size 10 to 100 kilobytes, a frame error rate of at most 10 to the power of minus 2. As an advanced requirement, we wanted to push the data rate even further.
Jeter Fredrik.
Hey, jag heter Adrian.
Jag heter Johan.
Jag heter Mathieu.
Jag heter Johan.
Jag heter Peter.
Jag heter Daniel.
Jag heter Natasha.
For the solution, we implemented three different systems. The first system was implemented for us to learn more about the hardware and the software. The second system was implemented as a fully functioning OFDM system. Lastly, we designed a third system. This was, however, only simulated in MATLAB. This video will focus on the second system. The transmitter was implemented as a standard OFDM transmitter. However, in the C++ implementation, we're not using channel coding and source coding. The receiver detects the transmission by measuring the power of the channel. We then begin by cross-correlating the received data and the training sequence in order to get the beginning of the sequence. We make a rough estimate on the channel based on an FIR filter that will be used to initialize the Kalman filter on the pilots. After removing the cyclic prefix, we correct the phase inside the OFDM symbol, and we go back to the frequency domain by using the FFT. We then perform a Kalman filter on the pilots in the time domain, both in amplitude and in phase, to filter out the measurement noise of the channel. To estimate the channel in each subcarrier, we use linear interpolation. Hard decoding is made since we're not using channel coding in the C++ implementation, and the bits have now been received. Here, I launch the receiver. The receiver listens to the channel to hear if something is being transmitted. Then we launch the transmission. We transmit and then receive a signal modulated with QPSK with 0-bit error rate. Here we use the same procedure, but in this case we modulate the signal with 16 QAM. The bit error rate is here 0.2% since there is no channel coding in this case. Finally, we transmit a picture, modulated in QPSK with 0-bit error rate. There are no errors and we can decode perfectly. The first system managed to achieve a data rate of 12.4 megabytes per second at 0-bit error rate, with a decoding time of 5.56 milliseconds. The second system had the best performance at 18 megabytes per second without coding, with a delay of 16 milliseconds for a code word. The third system had a 57 megabytes per second data rate with a bare of 0.29 in offline testing and needs further work.
What we doing live? Echoes in eternity.